Hello, my name is Anne Sawyer. Today I will be talking to you about the question, what is worth? And to exemplify this, I have a personal example from the Model UN, which happened this year. The real-life situation which I present with you today was that I am the president of the Model UN Club. However, this year, in attempting to start up the club again, we ran into financial problems, and eventually the advisor just said, get rid of it. I was very distraught about this, actually, and just kind of sparked the question of what would cause someone else to put less value on something than yourself. What is the difference in perception? So the decontextualization of this issue is to sort of unpack the real life situation which I just mentioned. I have a couple of things to talk to you about. The first being, what exactly does the Model UN accomplish? To me, it is essentially a debate club. You go and you learn skills in writing resolutions, you learn how to parliamentary procedure, talking with people of different races. I've met people from completely different races of mine, religions, ethnicities, all of that. It just gives you a different perception, and that's kind of why it is significant. It teaches you to work with people that you might not run into in your normal setting. And why does it matter to me? It's exactly as I just said. I'm a person that really appreciates a different perception on the matter, and that always kind of helps me to form my own opinion on certain things. How would it benefit others? Well, it doesn't only work for me, it works for everyone in the club. And I have found that there is a very high interest rate in the club, which has contributed to my level of distraught over the fact that it is not seen of value, seemingly. What would cause someone to think less of the club? What are the differing perceptions? One thing that I really go into or really hit hard is the financial thing. You will see that the school may put more into the sports rather than the Model UN Club or maybe the arts because they get more out of the sports. That's where they earn their money from. What bias do I hold? Now this is sort of kind of the flaw here. As you can see, I am an advocate for the Model UN, and that can contribute to the bias that I hold towards people that do not have the same perception as me. So the knowledge question. Specifically looking at the Model UN Club, MUN, as an example, what factors determine worth and should individual placement of value be factored into said worth? The areas of knowledge I have here are the human sciences and ethics and the ways of knowing our emotion and reason. Here we have the human sciences. The human sciences are just anything that involves human, kind of like the anthropology, I suppose you could factor in. Here we have ethics. Ethics are the values, the fairness, the morale, all of that in which encompasses. And then over here we have emotion and reason, which shows a bit of a contradiction, but at the same time they work together in decision making, which goes heavily into what we create work from. So for the first case scenario, we have human sciences. And human sciences can be explained in part as human behavior, or how we act and react. And worth is defined by humans, and in this case, as well as other cases such as currency value. So a way to easily describe worth is through currency, like money, monetary value. Though money, a dollar bill, is just a piece of paper, we place worth on it so that we can use it as a value to get things that we want. And therefore, worth is granted on terms of what it will do to benefit the individual or the community. And furthermore, this can explain the lack of attention paid to the specific club of Model UN at this school. And that goes back to relate to the whole sports and then the Model UN or the arts or the whatever you have it. Because we get money out of things like the sports or the musical, the school will put more into that. because they get more out. Whereas with the Model UN, they get some recognition, but they don't get the monetary value. And that's where the worth comes from. And this is quite interesting, I found, is there is a difference between individual and communal senses of worth, which can be used as a counterclaim to the specific argument on the value, if not differentiated. So by that, I mean everyone has an individual worth of something, and then someone has the communal sense of, or a group of people would have the communal sense of worth. That's like me looking at the Model UN and then the school looking at the Model UN. The school might not think it's worth much because they don't see the monetary value that they place the most worth on, whereas I individually see it is highly valuable to both me and the other students within it. And that is kind of the counterclaim. Yep. All right, so ethics. Ethics are the moral principles of the human being that drive our behaviors through actions and reactions. Very similar to human sciences because ethics are kind of what compose and drive what we do. And this defines more of why we store bias to certain aspects, which therefore determines where we put the worth or value. Where do we place value on something, and therefore it is worth? For instance, why would I care about the Model UN and another person not care at all? And that goes back to just the individuality of what we place value on, and therefore what we have worth in. And this is another instance in the story from the beginning, dealing with what a person prioritizes as important, all the way to not so important. And each differing set of morals and ethics will provide a new counterclaim, especially when it comes to the bias of value. Again, repeating, every person has different ethics and morals, and therefore will base their decisions off of such. Therefore, giving their value or bias, and furthermore, determining what they place value on, and furthermore, claiming their worth on certain aspects. Okay, lastly, my last sort of claim is goes into emotion and reason. I have a little bit of audience interaction, if you will. Ashley, ask yourself, what matters the most to you? Your values, your moral. Okay. And then ask yourself why.
No one can tell me what to believe in, and I believe it's not right to do so because I am my own person.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you can answer it then. All right. One more person. Mr. Fletcher. What matters to you the most?
I'd say family.
Family. Can you answer why?
I just think family is the most important thing that you have. Mm-hmm. Because they're going to be there for you, and hopefully you're going to be there for them, regardless of what you go through in life.
Okay, so you can answer the why as well. Some people cannot. And this is you, both Ashley and Mr. Fletcher, and I'm sure everyone else who is answering the questions in their mind. This is you evaluating your own emotions and reasons. For instance, my emotions work to determine my reasoning as to why I consider this particular club incredibly important. Your emotions go into the first question as to what matters to you the most. Ashley said her morale. Mr. Fleischer said his family. But then asking yourself why goes into your reasoning, which shows that emotions and reasons, they truly do work together. They're not as different or as contrasting as a lot of people say. They're more of a juxtaposition, if you will. And then furthermore, determines the worth you place on a certain aspect of your life, such as the school Model UN Club for me, personally. Once more, it's gonna determine what you place worth on, and that's how worth fits into emotion and reason, specifically in the two questions I posed to you earlier. Like with ethics, each person will hold different emotions towards a particular item, event, or people, and therefore reasoning will be skewed in this manner. And this is sort of the counterclaim, once again, going with the individuality of a person, and just saying that they have they hold different biases towards it. So not everyone's going to have the same amount of worth, and that determines where it is placed. All right. So to conclude, worth is determined by both the individual and the communal input, which is further explained in depth by the human sciences, ethics, emotion, and reason. Such as with the Model UN Club example, the school looks at a picture from a mostly financial standpoint, thus a lack of the need for the Model UN. While the students involved look at it as a personal opportunity to achieve gain through diplomacy and other international interests that they may or may not have. The question remains as to which point wins out, and the heart of the matter is that they both work together to form worth and value in total. Each standpoint must set aside their differences of reasoning and work to make Model UN live on, but not become a costly expenditure. This goes for other objects in life, as everything must have balance. So essentially, you have to work with the communal and the individual sense of value and worth to make it work, essentially. And the flaw with my conclusion is that the individual and community don't always work together. And what happens when the balance is thrown off? Well, when the balance is thrown off, normally things like what happened this year happen, where it just doesn't happen at all. That's why you have to work to fix it. You can't just say, well, it doesn't matter anymore. Obviously, it does. That's why you have to work to fix it and reestablish the value or the worth and kind of reanalyze it, if you will. All right, so linking back to the knowledge question, which I have back here at the bottom, and it says, in specifically looking at the Model UN Club and UN as an example, what factors determine worth, and should individual placement of value be factored into the worth? So linking back to that, Model UN is simply one example. The idea of worth and value could be placed on pretty much anything, like with your morals, your family, and as a previous project, I believe, mentioned, the arts inside of schools as well, going with that whole budget cutting thing. And then speaking of diplomacy, working together may seem simple, but trust me, it's really not. It's really, really, really hard to get along with other people. And that's why a sense of value is difficult to create universal. And this is also seen on the government spectrum, which I have here, the political spectrum, as well as in religions, certain religions. What do you place value on? That's kind of the communal value, such as you see the liberals or the conservatives, they place value on certain things, therefore that determines their overall worth. Certain religions will place value on their own aspects, and that will determine their worth. And to conclude, worth is essential to both the human mind and society as a whole. It is simply where we collide in our systems of values, individual or communal, that cause the issues that we see today. So worth and value, they both matter. You have to work with the communal and the individual. That is my opinion. You have to kind of smash them together, come up with a compromise to determine the value. And if you have to reanalyze, then you have to reanalyze. That's how life works. You have to continuously fix something as it's bound to break in the end. Citations. Thank you for listening. Do you guys have any questions at all for me? Yes.
What do you value the most in life?
What do I value the most in life? I didn't even ask myself that question. Probably my perception in life. I like how it constantly changes and just grows, and I love to learn about different people, different aspects of life. That's why I really love this class so much, actually, because it taught me a lot about that, and just continuously growing and helping and working towards the ultimate goal of just being able to kind of give back what I have been given.
Great job. Good job.